There are chords everywhere on the guitar. There are scales everywhere on the guitar. And there are connections between those scales and chords everywhere on the guitar. But that can feel really daunting, overwhelming. The truth of it is that we don't need to hold all that information in our mind all at once. We just need little pieces at the right moment that we need them. So if you memorize just a few great chord and scale connections, you'll find that whenever you're playing certain chords, you'll see the scale pop up immediately. It more like a big puzzle. And sure, guitar and music theory is a giant puzzle. There is so much that we can potentially learn and have fun learning. But we don't need the entire picture all at once. If we just take those little tiny pieces and we memorize those pieces really well, then whenever we come across a certain situation or chord shape on the guitar, we start to see those little opportunities. They pop up in our mind. They start to show up on the fretboard for us. And we're playing, and bam, there it is, that little piece. Let's say we're on one of these G bar chords. I mean, this is a major bar chord. This is in so many songs we couldn't possibly count. That's G major at the third fret. You can just remember that whenever you're on one of these standard major bar chord shapes, there's a little tiny scale that's just two frets above, and it's such an easy scale shape. It's the easiest. It's like this. That's just six notes, but remember, I mean, pentatonic is really just five notes anyway, right? What is that scale? It's a little piece of the major pentatonic scale. And if you've been watching my videos for a while now, you might get the idea of how important I think major pentatonic is for connecting chords with scales. So try this right now. Just hit that G major chord there, and then move up two frets and play the six notes. Something really simple or something really complex, depending on your current level. G chord. Hammer-ons work really well with this kind of technique. You can walk back down. You'll notice I did a little bend on that D string. And back to the G root there, right? So let's take G chord. Move up the two frets, play around with those six notes. Could bend this guy. Walk back. Goes like this. Now you might say, what are those six notes? They are a part of a major pentatonic shape, and it's not the easy shape. So you might not be familiar with the entire shape. A lot of people call it shape number three. But it doesn't really matter if you're not that familiar with shape three, because you're just going to use these six notes for now anyway. Because these six notes, when they're played kind of low down, right? That actually works really well, because when we're playing rhythm guitar, we don't want too much high-pitched noodling. We tend to want just some little riffs that we can create in between the chords. Now, if you want, you can memorize shape three if you haven't already. The whole shape is like this. I know a lot of my students kind of avoid shape three because they find it a little bit tricky, especially when you get to the G and the B strings. But the lower end of this shape is like magic because it's so easy. These six notes in a row do hammer-ons, right? And just remember, this is a good one to bend. And that, here is a really important one, your root in this little shape is here. And the beautiful thing about major pentatonic is that we can move it to whatever major chord we're on. So if we're in the key of G, we're going to play the 4 chord. And if you know how that works, that means that the 4 chord is C in the key of G. Why? Because G, A, B, C. Simple. So let's just take this G major chord and move it all the way up to the 8th fret, because then it becomes C. And we can do the exact same trick, because we remember that whenever we have this basic major chord shape here, that means that 2 frets up, we have this shape 3 major pentatonic. And there's the chord, right? Let's hear that back and forth. I'm gonna play this loop, and it's got some G, and then it's got some C. This week's lesson, I'm going to include some of the basic tabs for you on my website for free. But remember, we have started a Patreon group now, and they're going to have loads more tabs, loads more video lessons, and extra practice tips so that you can get better at this very technique that we're doing in this video. The Patreon link is below. And you'll notice that when I play it as C, the bend is in the same place. The root is in the same place, the root of C in this case, right? Because C is a better note to resolve when we're on the C chord. Of course it is. It's the root of that chord. And now we're doing something that is actually quite harmonically complex, because we are playing the notes of G major over the G chord, and we're playing the notes of C major pentatonic over the C chord, and resolving on a C note. This is like the holy grail that people always talk about. People are always asking, oh, how can I solo over the chords? How can I change scales to fit a chord? And you can see that with the right methods, it's pretty easy. So let's make this a little more interesting. That shape 3 happens to have a blue note right on the low E string, and it's perfect. It's positioned in such a great spot that allows us to move from the chord, transition into this little shape 3 using the blue note, which makes it sound kind of funky, kind of bluesy, kind of soul R&B, and it's right there under our fingers. So let's hear what that sounds like. Right? I can walk from the chord, just shift up, play the blue note. Maybe up to the root there. Very nice. So let's move it up to C. It's going to be in exactly the same place in relation to C, right? Because we take C bar chord, and we've memorized now that whenever we're on this shape of bar chord, we have these 6 notes above it and that blue note. So let's hear that with the loop. I'm gonna go G to C, just like I did before, but I'm gonna throw in some blue notes this time. Also want to be able to shift to the 4 chord without having to move all the way up the fretboard. Not there's anything wrong with moving all the way up the fretboard. As you can hear, it already sounds cool, so why not? But we don't want to limit ourselves, right? Of course, when we move a major bar chord up this way, we have to change the shape, and it becomes this difficult one, we sometimes call it. So now we have a different bar chord shape, and that means that that little trick that we've been doing has to be altered slightly. But here is the good news, that it's still so easy, and we still have that easy six-note shape. It just starts on the A string. So if here is my C chord, I'm just going to move up two frets, as I did before, and there's my six-note shape starting from the A string. So file away in your memory that whenever you're on a major bar chord with its root on the low E, like we were doing for G, this six-note system works. With the blue note, right? And now that whenever we're on a major chord with its root on the A string, and we're using this bar chord shape, which we do in billions and billions of songs, two frets up is the same shape, but just starts on the A string, because the chord did too. And you might have noticed, I just played the blue note, and the blue note is in the same space. Now, here's a little fine print. Once we've moved up to this C chord, or once we're on a, let's say, this major chord shape with its root on the A string, and we do this trick, it's not actually shape three anymore. You know what it is? Thinking. Anybody? It's the easy shape. It's the easy shape because, like I said in one of my other videos, I think it was called The Most Useful Lick I Ever Learned. It is this. It is the most useful lick I ever learned. We just do it with a slide. There's the most useful lick I ever learned, and it puts me in that shape. Or if I expand the whole shape, it puts me in the entire easy shape of major pentatonic. And we can see that in the easy shape, that is also where we have those six notes in a row. Right? With the blue note. So it's kind of like a happy coincidence. Well, we're doing the same thing on a different chord in a different space, on a different shape. I mean, wow, it's like when you, if you try to do all the calculating, man, I don't do all that calculation when I'm improvising or playing rhythm in the band and doing these kinds of licks. I'm just seeing the opportunity because I've memorized the opportunity. The opportunity is this. Whenever we're on this kind of bar chord shape, we always have this major pentatonic right here. These six notes by themselves are great. And remember that even though this is easy shape, this is C major pentatonic easy shape. And my root is on pinky, right? That's first finger pinky rule. If you take lessons with me, you always learn first finger pinky rule. And that means that when my pinky is on the root, that is major pentatonic. Okay, let's put all this together. I'm gonna do G in this area like we were doing before, but instead of moving all the way up to C at the eighth fret, I'm gonna use C here, this other bar chord shape from the third fret. Okay, let's see if I can do it. Here we go. That was the full easy shape. If you've enjoyed this technique, connecting chords with scales, remember we've got some of the tabs on my website for free, and we've got our Patreon with the link is below. Plus, we've got many more videos on this technique on this YouTube channel, and I'm going to put one of those videos right here on the screen for you. My name is Blue Morris, and I teach guitar lessons in Vancouver. Thanks very much.